Hello world! If we're talking about quantum physics and multiverse theory, I'm in this world and in parallel worlds at the same time. Worlds can be similar, but also completely different. Today we will show the development of information technology. In ancient times, simple manual devices were used. An example is the abacus. Later, and until the 20th century, a slide rule was used for division and multiplication. More complex machines were also created, such as the differential analyzer and analog computers. The results of analog machines represented physical quantities, which were expressed in the decimal systems. The mid-20th century marked the beginning of the digital revolution. The first computers were huge machines, weighing tons. Since they were as big as a room, they were also called mainframe computers. Their power only increased slowly. For comparison, when the US landed on the moon, their entire computing system performance was at the level of today's smartphone. They basically landed on the moon with a calculator. This digital era began using a simple and reliable binary system. System of one and zeros. It is important to note that there are not numbers in the classical sense in a row. It is not the number 1 following a 0. They are the equivalents of opposites. A better expression would be off and on. Exactly open and closed, like a light switch.
Off, on. Off, on. Or 1, 0, 1, 0, or open, close, open, close.
0 off, 1 on. 0 or 1 is actually 1 bit. 8 bits then make up a byte. This whole miracle was started by the electronic component transistor. Their number essentially determines the performance. In 1965, Gordon Moore defined that the number of transistors in an integrated circuit would double every 2 years. This led to an exponential increase in performance and a reduction in the price of electronic devices. Moore's law is an exponential graph. The problem which the digital age and the growth of power is the shrinking of transistors. We are currently pushing the limits of our capabilities, which the size of our components, the possibility is to combine power. In digital technology, a plus is added between the next unit of power. But this is not a stunning vision of power growth. We are currently entering the age of quantum computers. The basic unit is qubit. The big difference from bit is that it can be 1 or 0 or both at the same time. When we add another qubit, we talk about particle entanglement. Space disappears and two entangled particles respond in the same way to a stimulus, regardless of distance. But be careful, there is a condition here, the particles must be hidden. If quantum particles are unobserved, we can talk about their superposition. This can be any variant. The definition can be the Copenhagen interpretation and Schrödinger's cat. Any observation or measurement will cause the wave function to collapse and the particles decide to take only one specific option. Quantum computers code hold the promise of a meteoric rise in performance, because unlike digital computers, where performance is calculated plus, in quantum computers it is multiplied. Today quantum computers are huge. Superconducting ones are also very cold, approaching absolute zero temperature. Microsoft might be the game changer with their Majorana processor. Now I will make a demo computer for better understanding. It works off the principle of nonlinear dynamics. Power supply, mouse, and our Qbit. Our Qbit decides 0 or 1 way. And let's go. Eight. Number 4. One, two, three, four.
One more time.